My name's Ryan Davey. I'm a wildlife filmmaker and conservationist on bonamanzigamereserve, which is situated just outside of Kluwe in a province called Zululand, South Africa. And we are home to an abundance of wildlife, including elephants, giraffe, buffalo, large herds of antelope, zebra, wildebeest, an abundance of bird life, and of course we are home to the white and black rhino. Right now we're in the midst of a rhino war, where it's taking its toll on the amount of rhino that have been poached for the perpetuated myth that that the horn provides some medicinal value, which is really untrue, since the substance itself is keratin, no more value than your fingernail. The rhino war is also taking its toll on the amount of people that are killed every year protecting the rhino, and of course the perpetrators that are somewhat involved and also forced into it because they may be threatened with their lives. Unfortunately, it is a bit of a cat and mouse game, in that sometimes we're the cat and sometimes we're the mouse. Of course, there are measures that we take in order to protect the rhino. One is that we place tracking devices on the rhino horn itself so we can monitor them on a day-to-day basis. Another is strict anti-poaching unit schedules, expensive fence lines with electric fences, and of course aircraft surveillance and drone surveillance. Lots of people on the ground and farm neighborhood watch. But all that aside, today is a good day on Bonamanzi because we are dehorning our rhino. And as sad as that may sound, it doesn't hurt the rhino in any way, other than a little bit of stress that it may cause for us to find the rhino, dart the rhino, dehorn, and then release them back into the wild without its means of protection. But it's either that or the rhino dies. So we find it a valuable substitute. Of course, dehorning rhino is a logistical and expensive process, in that first of all we have to find the rhino. So the team on the ground, which includes myself, have to track the rhino, find them, and somehow let the helicopter know where they are, and then of course allow the helicopter to have access to the rhino so that they can dart it, or then undergo the necessary process in order to dehorn the rhino. So we've been tracking this rhino all morning, and we suspect they're together, which is great, because that way we can do more than one at a time. But it all depends on what kind of foliage they're in. When they're in this thick stuff, we could be 5 meters away and we don't even see them. With Bonamanzi having several ecosystems, one being the sand forest, if for instance the rhino do traverse into the sand forest, it's very difficult to get them out. Sometimes we could see them 5 meters away and the drone will not pick them up. If the drone doesn't pick them up, then a helicopter wouldn't. So we have to try and flush them out into the open, either the savannah or the wetlands, so that the helicopter can have access to them and then they can get a clear shot with the dart. But of course sometimes that entails quite an expensive process, because it means the helicopter could fly around for an hour before it gets a visual on the rhino. Unfortunately, over the past month, we have had two attempts on our rhino, both of which involved a gunshot wound. Fortunately, I was able to spot the perpetrator with the thermal drone, but unfortunately, something was thrown at the drone and it fell out of the sky. It was enough to get the rhino out of harm's way so that we could take the necessary precautions in preventing it from happening again. These poachers are fueled by the idea that the more they dip the numbers, the more valuable the rhino horn becomes. The little that's left on the rhino horn doesn't quite substitute the risk involved in potential loss of life or limb. So that is our protection until, of course, the horn starts to grow again, and then the process repeats itself. We run a volunteer program here at Bonamanzi Game Reserve, and one of our students is a 13-year-old boy, and I must say it's very difficult for me to have to explain to him why it's necessary for us to dehorn the rhino. It's quite embarrassing as an adult member of the human race to have to explain to a young child that, the humans have this false perception that the horn provides medicinal value and some other value which is unspoken of. His first question is, well, why can't we find something else instead of the horn? That's a good question, and unfortunately what he's seen is that there is good and evil in the world, and the good that comes out of the evil is the fact that the need to protect such species from perpetrators provides an opportunity for people like me and him to find fulfillment and purpose in this life. So from Bonamanzi Game Reserve, we'd like to thank you all very much for your support, and to the sponsors that dehorned our rhino. We could obviously not have done it without you, so thank you very much. To our guests, thanks for your support. Thanks for following our films. Hope to see you soon. Keep smiling, stay positive, and find fulfillment in the things you do.